In this video, we're going to give you some critical updates on a previous video about Google Meet versus Zoom. Let's get started. Welcome to Mr. Cook's Corner, Education for Educators. This show is all about helping teachers grow in your craft. If this is your first time watching, welcome. Please consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell, liking our videos, and sharing this content with a friend. Our original video, Google Meet versus Zoom, and which is the better video conferencing software, was posted about a month and a half ago. If you haven't seen that yet, check it out right here. The reason why we're posting this video is because there's been a lot of updates in the last month and a half, as a lot of you viewers have posted, and thank you for those comments. I'm here right now to share with you the most important things that you need to know to keep you up to date as of May 12th. Okay, let's address the elephant in the room right now, Zoom security. And guess what? It's safe to use. No, there's no one in China trying to take your data, especially if you're a teacher with a classroom. Zoom security has been updated many times since the initial problems that they had. And yes, they did have problems at first, but they've addressed them. They've posted tons of updates and they've been very transparent about themselves in the process. I'm gonna post a link down below in the description so you can follow along yourself. It goes directly to the Zoom blog. It tells you exactly what they're doing. Also, part of this goes into how you're setting up your meetings in the first place. If you need help making sure your Zoom meetings are secure, I want you to check this link out. I've got a video for you right now for you to watch. As long as you're following these best practices like I've described, you are safe and secure. So please quit worrying. Okay, let's talk about Google Meet updates. Something really important that they've done is that they've opened it up to use to anybody. That means if you don't have an EDU account, you can still use Google Meet. This is only through September 30th, but for now, if you don't have an education account, you can now use Google Meet for free. Some other cool things that Google Meet has added include closed captioning, and although it doesn't work perfectly, you can still read what other people are saying, and you can actually type in what other people are saying if you want to provide closed captions for other people. And finally, they've given you a really good option to present a tab only, which if you're trying to show something in high quality, like a video, something including audio with it, you're gonna wanna use this mode, but it definitely ups the game for Google Meet. So there are three Chrome extensions that you're gonna want to add right off the bat for Zoom and for Google Meet. The first extension you're gonna want is Google Meet Grid View. And what this does is it mimics Zoom's ability to have up to 50 people on the screen at once. Currently, even with the updates, Google Meet only has up to 16 people. So by adding this extension, you're gonna allow yourself to see many more people all at one time. The other extension you're gonna wanna add for Google Meet is called Nod Reactions. And what this does, it mimics Zoom's ability to be able to show certain emojis and reactions as people are talking. This comes in especially handy when you're muted. If you're using Zoom, you're gonna wanna get the Chrome extension called Zoom Scheduler. And what this does is it gives you the ability to mimic Google Meet. When you go into Google Calendar and you create an appointment, you can now click on the video conferencing button and make it a Zoom meeting. This makes it function exactly like Google Meet does in their ecosystem. This is a vital addition for you Zoom users out there. Now I want to update you on some information that was presented in the first video, just to make sure we're playing fair. For Zoom, there was an error made. We can only have up to 100 people in a Zoom. I said 250, and that is my mistake. However, if you do have a pro account, you will be able to have that kind of limit, but that does cost money. So for the free account, Zoom only has 100 people. For Google Meet, they've allowed you to have up to 250 participants. Again, this is only until September 30th, and they will revert back to the 100 unless you have that EDU account. Also, they've increased your views from 4 people on a grid to 16. Again, you're gonna want that Chrome extension to not even worry about something like that. Google Meet, on the other hand, does not have the ability still to do virtual backgrounds or green screen capabilities. Zoom is still the only one between the two that can do that, so they do hold the upper hand there, just in case you're trying to mask yourself and where you're working. Both Zoom and Google Meet still have unlimited time capabilities, but do remember that Zoom will revert back to 40 minutes eventually, and you will have to get that pro account to extend that time limit. As far as the schedules and invitations, if you're using that Zoom scheduler, they are now the same. You can do the exact same thing in Zoom with a Google Calendar as you could with Google Meet. So that's definitely leveled the playing field. Moving on to chat options, the advantage still leans towards Zoom for one really important reason. Let me acknowledge though that when you're using the Google Nod extension, that really helps in order to raise your hand, show a thumbs up, give a round of applause, all those things that you're used to doing with Zoom. However, the biggest distinction and pain in the butt for Google Meet users is that you still cannot mute someone permanently. I may be able to put you on mute for a second, but you as a user in the meeting can just unmute yourself again. If you're in the business world, it's really not that big of a deal, as everybody is supposed to be acting professionally. But as a teacher of kids 12 and under, it's really a pain to have to mute somebody only to have them unmute themselves a second later. With Zoom, you have that ability to stop them from unmuting themselves. In regards to recording, with Google Meet, you can record your meetings. However, they are downloaded directly to your drive, and you have to hunt around for a second to find it. On top of that, other participants do not have the ability to record the meetings. You can, however, choose to share the recorded meeting with people just like you would with any other Google Doc. You'd have to go into the sharing permissions of that file. With Zoom, it's still a little bit simpler. You hit the record button, and when you exit the meeting, it asks for you where to download it. It goes onto your desktop, and from there, it's yours to do whatever you want with. Participants also have the option to record as well, though you do, as a host, have the ability to limit that. You can set it to where other people cannot record. It's just another security addition for Zoom that really helps you control your virtual meetings. And that's the other thing, is just hosting security in general. Zoom still has that upper hand. You can mute all. You can permanently mute people. You can remove people. The amount of options that you have to take control of your virtual classroom is nearly unlimited. And with all the patchwork they've done to the security flaws that were originally there, it's even that much better than before. When you toss in the ability to do breakout rooms, which is really a great way to take a large number of people, have them talking about topics in a smaller room, and then bring them back together, once again proves that yes, Zoom is the better software, hands down. Now, all you Google Meet fans out there, don't get me wrong, I'm a fan too. I love Google. I'm a Google certified educator and trainer. But if we're being objective and we're talking about all around performance, there's just really no comparison. In the meantime, check out these awesome videos for you to watch. If you like the content that you saw today, please consider subscribing and liking our videos. And if you have an idea for a video you'd like to see, be sure to hit us up, MrCooksCorner@gmail.com. See you next time. Bye.